They want to hang out where we hang out. And when they come to Port Lakaya, they expect to see Bahamian band playing or some sort of entertainment.
Joseph Cooler is not a business owner in the market, but he decided to attend the meeting. He believes the day can be considered as one of the most important days in the history of Port Lakaya.
I love this place. I maybe love it too much. And you know what? Mr. Romeco knows I love it more. More today than yesterday. And I hope that a year from today, these sisters are going to be, and the restaurateurs and the taximan and the whole thingam. I hope the joy and history, like Maflo say, boy, high tide lift all boats.
After the meeting, Terry Goldsmith encouraged business owners to stay positive.
If you fight and you lose, you gave it your best shot. Right? But 9 times out of 10, if you have that drive and energy to fight back and the will to win, you will win. I know, I've lived it, and I've benefited from it.
Romeco Knowles, ZNS Network News.
Mother's Day is just 3 days away. This is a time when most mothers are celebrated with special gifts, love, and flowers. Well, in this report, some business owners say business is picking up as the day approaches, and they have some unique items in stock. Italia Hall reports.
Are more like the gateway to the world, and without mothers there won't be any children, and life is all about giving.
Mother's Day is an annual observance celebrated across the world. Well, here in Grand Bahama, it appears as if some business owners are gearing up for the special day. At L&S Boutique, owner Chantel Adderley has prepared Mother's Day gift baskets, and she says so far customers are loving it.
They've always been the nurturers. They've always been those who could help and get the children to where they are today. So, you know, Mother's Day, they hold a special spot in my heart. So.
Over at the Raven Mall, several business owners are selling Mother's Day gift baskets, coffee mugs, photo frames, balloons, and more. Donna Rogers sharing why she decided to provide a selection of gifts for mothers at her booth.
I think it's very nice to give back to the mothers, especially the ones that are in single home families. And Mother is a special day. And not only for Mother's Day, but every day is Mother's Day.
Katie Lightborn of Triple Boots in the Raven Mall says they are also catering to the mothers this Mother's Day as well.
We decided to go all out for our mothers this year because we know it's been rough having Dorian and now the pandemic, and pretty much everybody has been experiencing a hard time. So we just want to show our appreciation to mothers during this time.
And she says so far, business is good.
Really good so far, especially now that the mall has been renovated, considering how it's been in the past. It's been really good so far.
Italia Hall, ZNS Network News.
It is a program geared toward training individuals working in the education and trade industry. The goal is to help certify instructors to be better able to teach their courses, in addition to helping them advance in their career paths and be recognized in a global market. Today, the National Center for Construction Education and Research with the Bahamas Technical and Vocational Institute receiving a trailer filled with a number of tools to assist with these technical programs, which are expected to start by the end of the month. Jamila Mizik reports.
President of the Bahamas Technical and Vocational Institute, Dr. Robert Robinson, says BTVI is ensuring that they have skilled tradespeople across the Bahamas, and they have adopted the National Center for Construction Education and Research, or NCCER program, which is a U.S.-based internationally recognized credential.
We've started to train younger people in that particular certification, and as well as trainers. So today we have about 70 trainers being trained here in Grand Bahama. They will be part of the training group who will then train about 1,000 students who will then go on to become master craftspeople, hopefully within the next 6 to 8 months. Today we're pleased to have a trailer of NCCER equipment, which is necessary to be part of this certification program. So we're bringing here to Freeport some equipment, tools and equipment that can be used for students to make sure that they meet the qualifications of the NCCER regulations.
Associate Vice President at BTVI Freeport Campus, Veronica Cawley, says they've been awaiting the tools for some time now and are elated that they can now begin using the tools in the programs by the end of this month.
We lost basically all of our equipment, so this is now getting us back to where we need to be normally. Our students are anxious, especially the ones who have finished from West Grand Bahama. They are anxious, and we now can get started with the program with the levels that they need to be working at.
BTVI Dean of Construction and Workforce, Alexander Darville, confirming that they received a number of tools valued between $70,000 to $80,000 of the NCCER standard. And he notes that they are currently working with the Rotary Club of Lucaya with a project on Sweetings Key.
We have some 22 students who have already started doing some practical work over there. And our plan is partnering with the Rotary, so we'll be able to get those persons certified in the NCCER core. We hope to get that started in the next 3 weeks, and then we'll get those persons trained up with the NCCER core with the mindset to get them to move on to the level one and the other levels. This is the time now when things are about to happen for us to start the training program. So when international companies come in looking for trade persons, we will be able to look at, or they'll be able to look at BTVI to see that we have started a process of training persons in the trades, so they don't have the look of bringing in persons to get started with their careers and their jobs.
Darville says it is important to teach the students how to properly operate, store, clean, and identify the tools.
A lot of labs do not have the tool that industry needs. And so NCCER is specific that if you're doing electrical carpentry masonry, and we ask for a brick shovel or we ask for a power hammer drill, you know how to identify those tools. So that is so, so important to us, that from day one, the persons leaving our program could go out there, get a job, but most definitely could be effective on what it is that they're looking for.
Jamila Misick, ZNS Network News.
A local pastor expressing concern this evening regarding several issues surrounding the island's premier healthcare facility, the Rand Memorial Hospital. The local leader says he witnessed firsthand various shortcomings that needs attention immediately for the smoother running of operations.
Pastor Barry Moore is sharing the experience of members of his congregation recently. He says a mother in the 8 Mile Rock community was experiencing stroke-like symptoms at her home, and when the family called for medical assistance, the ambulance took nearly an hour to arrive. Pastor Moore says this once again raises the age-old question about ambulances stationed in the Western District.
Why is there not an ambulance in 8 Mile Rock? 8 Mile Rock is the largest community in the Bahamas. Why is there not an ambulance service placed in 8 Mile Rock? Why is there not an ambulance service placed into West End? These far-flung places, people get sick, you know, they need urgent care. To be experiencing a stroke, and every second counts, and to be waiting on an ambulance for 45 minutes to an hour, it's much, much too long. And then we get to the hospital, and there's no information to the family. That's forthcoming. It's taking long, and family members are getting anxious, and one, you know, and just to see that unfolded was painful enough.
He says once admitted to the hospital, there was a major lack of communication between doctors and family members.
The same family got word that their loved one was being released from the hospital, came here at 6:30, 7 o'clock, upwards to 10:30. No meeting with anyone, nothing happened. Saturday now, I'm here with the family member wanting to speak with the doctor to find out what was going on. And the doctor never came out to speak to the family member concerning her mother.
Mara says that he is not bashing the healthcare workers, adding that he understands the difficult circumstances under which they are working at this current time. However, he says there must be some changes to the way patients and their family members are handled and communicated with.
I know that the situation, we're in a COVID situation, doctors are being maxed out, nurses are being maxed out, the staff here is being maxed out, short staff, tired, where I get that. But what I think needs to happen is the hospital, this is our only hospital here, and something needs to be put in place. We're hiring COVID police, COVID ambassadors. When a person comes here, let's get some healthcare ambassadors. You have students who are studying at UB, want to study medicine.
He further recommends the use of technology to follow up with after patient care.
We have sufficient technology. WhatsApp is prime. Okay, you get the number from a family member. WhatsApp, set up a Zoom meeting, a WebEx meeting, Teams. There's a number of technology platforms that can be used that we can involve the families in getting not just their loved one getting health care, but letting the family know exactly what is going on with their loved one. It is absolutely ludicrous that in the 21st century, in the world that we live in, everything's being digitized, everyone's coming up with technical programs, and we can't get information to people about their loved ones. That's unacceptable.
Now, we reached out to hospital administrator Sharon Williams. However, she declined an interview. She noted that the hospital is always looking for ways to improve the operations at the RAND through the use of technology. She said they are currently in the process of acquiring tablets, which are expected to help with enhanced communication.
Happy Mother's Day to Mary Boyd for being the best mother, grandmother, and great-grandmother.
Happy Mother's Day, Mommy, from all of us. You're precious in our hearts. We love you. Happy Mother's Day.
Thank you for being an exemplary mother and for loving us in your own special and unique way. From all of your girls, we love you, Mom.
To our precious mom, Gwendolyn Johnson, thank you for being our pillar of strength. Happy Mother's Day. We love you.
Get Mom this Mother's Day. Get her sweet treats from Yummy Treats. Contact 441-1880. It's just that yummy.
Welcome to Baja Gala. I'm Tanisha Carey. My products are actually handcrafted with natural materials. You can actually come in and personalize your own designs. So consider me your personal designer here in Freeport. One of my most popular designs are, of course, the Bahamian coin bracelets. You can actually come and choose from over 200 charms and personalize something for that special loved one in your life. Necklaces, pendants, bracelets, bangles, earrings, anything your heart desires. If you have an upcoming wedding, you know, please stop by. I can personalize and do your entire bridal party as well. Well, I actually do a lot of jewelry parties as well, for birthday parties. So, of course, there's intimate jewelry parties because of, COVID. I'm here in Freeport, but I ship throughout the Bahamas and I ship throughout the world as well. So you can also visit the website at www.bahagala.com. You can contact me directly at 688-BAHA, that's 2242, or 803-3732, that's also WhatsApp. Facebook is Baja Gala, Instagram is Baja.Gala. I'm located in the newly and beautifully renovated Raven Mall. The hours of operations are Monday through Saturday from 9:30 to 7 p.m.
Mom deserves a weekend out of the kitchen. Start with breakfast, lunch, then dinner all day this Saturday and Sunday at Off the Deep Edge Restaurant, Peel Street. Happy Mother's Day.
Con Ed Bahamas Mother's Day sale on all merchandise except AC units and special order cabinets, Freeport, Abaco, and Eleuthera. Follow on Facebook and Instagram for more information. Con Ed Bahamas. this Mother's Day, thank her for always being there with a sparkling gift set from Pandora Jewelry, starting at only $99. Gift sets available while supplies last. See store for details.
Happy Mother's Day from Pandora, Port Lakaya.
Dimension is having a Mother's Day sale Friday, May 7th and Saturday, May 8th. Take 15% off their home improvement store, Third Dimension, located on Yellow Pine Street. ZNS Shopping Network is the place for deals. Bahamas, get ready for our national launch coming June 1st, 2021. For the first time ever, any store can advertise their sale items or discounted coupons on ZNS and get TV and radio commercials at never-seen-before prices. So if you've got stuff and you want to put it on sale, we'll tell the entire Bahamas all about it. So merchants, log on to ZNSShoppingNetwork.com and click the Merchant Inquiry button today to get started.
Your number one news team covering the North. The Bahamas Tonight, Northern Edition.
Welcome back. It's that time of the evening when we take a look at sports. Let's check in with Jay Philippe.
Good evening, I'm Jay Philippe and welcome to sports. A major track and field event is expected to take place this weekend with some of the very top junior and senior athletes on full display. The inaugural James Turner Track and Field meet hosted by Falcons Athletics will sprint into action Saturday, May 8th at the Grand Bahama Sports Complex. Event coordinator Nikito Johnson says the meet will attract the top junior athletes on the island.
The age categories participating covers from all the way down from the under 7 all the way up to the open division. The highlight of the meet is really put on for the Carifta qualifiers, but that's the under 17 and under 20 division, and it's all about getting the kids back on the track. We don't know the situation with the Corypheus yet. We're supposed to know this weekend, but in the meantime, we have to stay focused on our prize and working towards goals.
Johnson says they are looking forward to seeing some Corypheus qualifying times on the weekend.
We have a good crop of kids here in Grand Bahama who have an excellent time, an excellent chance of making the Corypheus qualifying standards.
Stepping in as a sponsor for the first time event is James Turner, who says it's all about creating opportunities for young athletes.
I believe this is only the start. That's why we say this is the first annual, because we should be doing this bigger and better every year. If we could make it easier for our folks from Grand Bahama to qualify for these meets, it'll just be super. I mean, we can save time, we can save money, we can have a good time when we're doing it. And I can tell you something, Jake. There's nothing like the enthusiasm that's associated with sports, and that's been missing for a little while, so we got to work to make sure that it's returned.
And that's a quick check on sports right here in the North. I'm Jay Philippe. Be blessed.
Happy Mother's Day, Mary Ella Lang. From the children, Randolph and Theo, Judy May Pratt and Eleanor Stewart, and all those who cares for you.
To Marvin Minis Forbes, happy Mother's Day to the world's greatest mother and grandmother. From your children, grandchildren, family members, and friends, we love you always.
Mom, you are the best mother in the world. You're my sweetie pops.
We love you.
Happy Mother's Day.
Happy Mother's Day to our mother, Felicia. We love you. Third Dimension is having a Mother's Day sale Friday, May 7th and Saturday, May 8th. Take 15% off their home improvement store, Third Dimension, located on Yellow Pine Street.
The Grand Bahama Utility Company has made it easier for you to access your utility bill. So avoid the lines and receive your bill in real time when you visit us to update your account. All you need is a valid email address and a mobile phone number. For more information, contact our Utility Relations Department at 350-9009.
Treasure the love of your mother. Give her a gift she will treasure forever. Shop Bellevue Gifts and Supplies for that special personalized gift basket. Happy Mother's Day.
You all thinking about catching a trip? Get all fresh up and catch the sailing with Valeria Caribbean. Passenger prices start at only $120 per way. And you'll love the onboard amenities while you relax and enjoy the view. Plus, the ferry is secured with all the latest COVID-19 protocols. Once you're done shopping, you're back home in no time with no hassle getting your packages. Bins start at $150. And the best thing is when you travel with your cargo, you eliminate the manifesting fees. It's easy, fast, and affordable. Book your trip now at www.valeriacaribbean.com.
Delicious Mother's Day buffet at the Grand Lucayan. Cornish hen, grouper, lobster, macaroni, rice, cheesecake, and much more. Get tickets at Lighthouse Point Lobby. Phone 350-5000.
This Saturday, May 8th, Do It Center is having a 20% flash sale on bathroom wall light fixtures and housewares. Do It Center is also saying thank you and will be giving away three gifts to three lucky mothers. Do It Center carries a large variety of housewares, power tools, plumbing and electrical, hardware and paint. Open Monday to Saturday, 7 a.m. to 5 p.m., located at the Gold Rock Complex. Everything to complete that job for mom this season. Happy Mother's Day from Do It Center.
Island Bedding is the Bahamas' leading manufacturer in mattress sets. But did you know, we also carry top quality products like pillows, comforters, sheets, and much more. Our furniture line is also expanding to meet the needs of those rebuilding. We have bedroom sets, sofa beds, recliners, accent pieces, and so much more. Come and experience Island Bedding today, where everybody deserves their own island.
Hey guys, welcome back to Health Bites. Today's episode is going to be about testosterone, which is the most important male sex hormone. This is especially for the guys. So testosterone is important. It helps to build muscle, it helps with your energy level, and of course it helps with your sex drive. So if you're feeling low energy, low sex drive, you have excess fat, they can be symptoms of low testosterone. Some ways you can increase your testosterone are by getting lots of rest, eating a healthy, balanced diet, including foods such as broccoli, tuna, and eggs. Those are three foods helpful for testosterone. Another way is to take a testosterone booster, like this one here. Testosterone boosters help to increase your body's natural testosterone production, as well as the quality of your testosterone. Remember, if you need any of these supplements, we have them available at the Fitness Connection, locations both in Nassau and Freeport. Come check us out.
Covering the North. The Bahamas Tonight, Northern Edition.
Maia Lopez Israel, you are our Facebook friend of the day. We thank you so much for your continued support. That's going to do it for us here in the North, but be sure to stay tuned as the Bahamas Tonight continues. On behalf of the entire news team here in the North, I'm Megan Shepherd. Have a wonderful evening.
In the Bahamas Tonight, the National Report, legislation regulating a controversial proposed industry could be just weeks away. Human trafficking and the COVID-19 pandemic. And businesses forewarned about fake currency. Those stories and more when the Bahamas Tonight, the National Report, continues.
May 10th, 1980, the date etched in Bahamian history.
One of the Cuban MiGs fly over the vessel.
They came back with another blaze of fire, and this time they hit the vessel.
straight down the center of the vessel.
And I saw my shipmates scurrying and running and screaming, some starting to jump into the water because by then the flamingo had caught fire.
And the killing of four young Bahamian men.
Fendrick Starr, we were swimming together. All of a sudden he started shouting, help, help, help. I said, swim, man, swim.
I get ready for chase. Matsu called me from wake. Then she tell me what happened. But I wasn't thinking. None was my, that was my thought.
Join at NSTV 13 as we bring you The Ultimate Sacrifice, the HMBS Flamingo story with Beverly Curry, Sunday, May 9th at 8 p.m.
This portion of the news brought to you by BTC's Dollar Holla Deals.
Good evening, I'm Akush Lapindo. Welcome to the Bahamas Tonight, the National Report. Thanks so much for tuning in. It's long been a hot button issue, but now that broad consultation has taken place with stakeholders and a preliminary decision has been made on what constitutes legal products, the government could very well bring marijuana legislation to Parliament before the upcoming budget. Our Keishla Adderley spoke with the Attorney General on the issue.
When the cabinet meets next week, it could be making its final determinations about marijuana legislation. Attorney General, the Honorable Carl Bethel, detailed what's being proposed as it relates to how hemp products will be constituted in accordance with the law.
The definition that we're going with is that anything that has THC within the cannabis plant of more than 0.3% is considered psychoactive, and therefore within the remit of the Dangerous Drugs Act. Anything with less than 0.3% THC is not psychoactive. It does not meet the standard of being a dangerous drug and is available and will be available in due course to the development of various cannabis hemp industries.
The Bahamas National Commission on Marijuana recommended that marijuana be decriminalized conditionally, suggesting that individuals be allowed to have a maximum of 1 ounce of the substance in their possession without prosecution. Since then, many other groups have been part of the process of establishing legislation on the controversial issue.
We've had meetings now, consultative meetings over Zoom, with potential entrepreneurs, investors potentially, persons of Bahamians who are living abroad, who already have businesses in terms of the dispensation or sale of cannabis edibles or other things like that. So we had both Bahamians who are resident here and Bahamians resident abroad who were on the call along with the Minister of Agriculture.
Mr. Bethel explains that Cabinet is working to complete its process ahead of sending the proposal to Parliament within the next few weeks.
The Dame is working on with the Law Reform Commission. Dame Anita Allen is working with the Law Reform Commission now to put all of the different suggestions that we deem to be, we think are going to be workable, because not everything suggested is workable at the present time, into the redraft of the bill. That will then be submitted to me, I'm told, by the end of tomorrow afternoon. And then on Saturday or Sunday, I'm going to organize a meeting of the ministerial committee, subcommittee of cabinet, that has been charged with this consultation process. And we will go through the bill line by line. And then we're trying to see whether or not we're in a position to bring it forward either this week or the next week for cabinet to approve at the end of this process.
Meantime, the Marijuana Commission also recommended medicinal, recreational, and religious uses for the drug. Specific provisions are expected to be detailed in the bill, expected before the end of the budget period. Keish Latterly, ZNS Network News.
Well, meantime, Cabinet has given the green light to expunge the criminal records of those charged with marijuana possession. National Security Minister, the Honorable Marvin Dame, shared as much with reporters this morning.
If you would have been arrested, charged, and convicted for marijuana possession, not possession with intent to supply, possession, our Cabinet has agreed led by the Prime Minister, that these persons should have that expunged from their records. And this is all in an attempt for us to demonstrate to the Bahamian people that we are a government of second chance.
Dames went further to hint a possible timeline.
Once all of the official paperwork is finalized, and then we will begin the process. But what I'm telling you is that's the direction we're going as a government. It's all in line with our giving persons clemency, expungements of records.
Officials of the National COVID-19 Vaccine Consultative Committee preparing to roll out the second dose of the AstraZeneca vaccine this coming Monday, May 10th. Vaccinees should expect an email alert as to when they can book their appointment. Keep in mind that appointments can be made at any available vaccination site. The Prime Minister among the first Bahamians to get the second shot.
I look forward to receiving my second jab or vaccination shot very soon. And while there, I will try to convince them and the remainder of Bahamas why it's necessary to receive the vaccine as opposed to the disease COVID.
The Prime Minister again underscored the message of limiting social gatherings, which can further spread the deadly virus.
And you want to remind the public that we are still in a pandemic, and I urge them to continue avoiding large gatherings, adhere to the protocols and the amount of parties and social events that are occurring. I'd ask them to decrease on such events, and the police will be doing their job there, their COVID officers.
In related news, there's a message circulating on social media purporting to be an urgent request for people vaccinated with AstraZeneca, claiming that those experiencing COVID-like symptoms for more than 3 days should share personal details and information about the vaccine administered. The Ministry of Health making it clear that its surveillance unit is not behind the message, and consequently, it is not approved communication. The public then is strongly advised to seek information from reliable sources like the Ministry of Health, the Office of the Prime Minister, the World and Pan American Health Organizations, and to guard against receiving and/or sharing misinformation about the virus and the vaccine. As it stands, all Bahamians and permanent residents 18 years and over are eligible to take the COVID-19 vaccine. Well, now 5 people in the intensive care unit battling COVID-19. Those 5 part of the 52 in hospital with the virus. This is there were 42 recoveries on Wednesday for a total of 9,733 on record. The latest COVID dashboard also reflecting 52 new infections, 45 of them on New Providence. The other 7 are scattered among Grand Bahama with 2 and 1 each on the Berry Islands, Abaco and Andros. The locations of the other 2 cases are pending. 1 new confirmed case show a history of travel within 14 days. 404 tests were completed on Wednesday, 10 of them repeats and 7 showing inconclusive results. The Sandilands Rehabilitation Center has a new acting hospital administrator in the person of Jessica Cartwright. The appointment took effect April 6. Cartwright began her health administration career with the Public Hospitals Authority in 1999 as a trainee administrative cadet at the Princess Margaret Hospital. She moved through the ranks to become senior assistant hospital administrator in 2003. And in 2016, Sandals Deputy Hospital Administrator. Cartwright was the hospital's client project manager, taking the lead on many major capital projects, the most recent, the Urgent and Emergency Care Project. This includes the hospital's emergency department's phased expansion. Well, still to come, a brief meeting for senators and the first regional trafficking in-person seminar takes place here in the Capitol. Those stories and more from the National Report continues.
And remember to tune in to the Morning Edition with LaDawn Davis and Charles Fisher at 7 o'clock weekday mornings. We also have news updates at every hour starting at 2 p.m. You can then watch live at 5 with Amajal Knowles, followed by the Bahamas Tonight, the Northern Edition, at 6:30, and the National Report live at 7 p.m., all right here on the ZNS Network.
This portion of the news is brought to you by Sun Oil Limited Shell, fueling journeys that matter.
Welcome to a world where hope is still loud, where dreams are still relevant, and determination has no substitute. Welcome to a nation where the people are still warm, resilient, and innovative. And Commonwealth Bank is at the center of it all, giving innovation and progress an extra push for more than 60 years. We're here for Bahamians because we are Bahamian. Commonwealth Bank, your leader in personal banking services.
The $20 combo, unlimited talk, yo, to every network you know. Across the Bahamas, I got 6 gigs of data, plus unlimited cha-cha. It's a scroll over two. Now let me check my people on Facebook and WhatsApp. BTC is where it's at. I rock my combo.
Your BTC 10-day combo is now only $20 and is supersized with a new low price.
BTC, do it again.
You know that feeling you get when you have an uncontrollable desire for fried chicken? That's the KFC, a substance that stimulates your senses to identify the aroma of our secret recipe or an extra crispy crunch from any distance. It's invisible to the naked eye, but you can feel it traveling throughout your body, taking control so you can enjoy a juicy bite of KFC. Ignite your senses with KFC.
This portion of the news was brought to you by McDonald's. McDonald's, I'm loving it.
In news from Parliament, senators met briefly this morning, just long enough to lay a compendium of bills. The first reading of the Securities Industry and Insurance Amendment Acts were read in the upper chamber. The Senate was then suspended to Friday. At that time, members will proceed with second reading of those bills before committal and passage. The Senate resumes at 10 a.m. Well, the bills move on to the Senate after being passed in the lower chamber last evening. Minister of Financial Services, Trade, Industry and Immigration and Member of Parliament for Yamacraw, the Honorable Ellsworth Johnson, wrapped up the debate responding to the opposition leader's concern on employment.
The never intention for the commissions and for itself in a private contractual arrangement. You know that there is no absolute right to work. And so persons can hire or terminate those persons who they don't want to be in their employment. Sometimes we may just have to compensate them, right? And so we take on what he says and on the advisement, and we'll move forward.
Putting an end to the multi-million dollar trafficking in persons industry, the focus of the first ever such regional meeting held here in the capital. The theme, a regional discussion on successes and challenges in anti-trafficking activities. The inaugural event, a joint initiative of the Bahamas and the U.S. Embassy. Minister of National Security, the Honorable Marvin Dame, says it comes as traffickers are taking advantage of the COVID-19 pandemic to advance their nefarious agendas.
We're focusing on this pandemic. There are others who are focusing on exploiting others and committing other forms of transnational organized crime. And what we are doing here today is just reminding those persons that we haven't relented.
The Bahamas, among those that has taken a strong stand against human trafficking, also known as modern day slavery.
We cannot allow it to take root here in the Bahamas. And the Bahamas has been one of the leaders, not only regionally, but globally. We continue to maintain our Tier 1 status, which speaks volumes to the efforts that we continue to make, that we will continue to pursue you, pandemic or not. And that's why this is certainly important.
64 Haitian nationals were escorted to a waiting Bahamas Air charter flight early this morning and sent back home. The 52 males, 11 females, and one minor were repatriated to Port-au-Prince, immigration officials assuring that the health, welfare, and safety of their officers, as well as that of their counterparts and migrants, remain the highest priority in this COVID-19 environment. From the courts this evening, another young man finds himself on the wrong side of the law. 21-year-old John Elliott was today charged with the April 4th murder on Nassau Street. Based on preliminary reports, the victim was playing dominoes when a man he's familiar with showed up and opened fire, shooting him in the abdomen. The victim was rushed to hospital where he died. Fast forward to a month later, and the alleged assailant appeared before Chief Magistrate Joanne Ferguson Pratt. In addition to the murder, Elliott was also charged with possession of a firearm with the intent to endanger the lives of Ebenezer Frazier and Dexter Harris. Elliott was remanded. He returns to court on July 22nd for a voluntary bill of indictment. The Financial Crimes Investigation Branch warning businesses and residents across the country to be on the lookout for counterfeit money and fraudulent checks in circulation. Fern Carey has this update.
Police are on the hunt for the persons responsible for passing counterfeit $50 and $20 notes off to unsuspecting victims and business owners over in Harbor Island, Eleuthera, with persons getting more creative and using various techniques to generate counterfeit notes. Chief Superintendent Matthew Edgecombe says the trend is extremely concerning, especially in these tough economic times.
It is very concerning to me when fake counterfeit notes show up on the family island, especially for small communities on the family island. We are watching this very carefully. As the situation develops, we'll be following any information or any leads to determine the source of these counterfeit notes.
The chief superintendent says fraudsters usually choose a certain time during the day to pass off the fake money to their victims.
Well, we find out that many of these persons pass these notes, like in dark areas, or say, if you want a liquor store in the nighttime, they will pass the notes off. And I must say, sometimes you might not know that they are fake. Like on these occasions, they didn't realize this is fake monies until they deposited to the bank, to their banks, various banks. There is a penalty for it. It could be jailed or pay a hefty fine.
Now, the fake currency, which showed up in Eleuthera, has since been seized, and Chief Superintendent Edgecombe is advising business owners to invest in counterfeit detection devices to prevent losses to their business. He also indicated that two males are expected to be arraigned soon for attempting to cash in on fake Bahamas Mortgage Corporation checks, one valued at over $70,000 and the other over $80,000.
Two suspects went into the bank and try to negotiate these fraudulent checks. Also, of action of the police, we have them in our custody, two males, and hopefully we have them to go to court sometime on, hopefully Friday, if not Friday, then Monday. I think probably tie up all our loose ends with this investigation.
Now, if you become aware of the whereabouts of any counterfeit currency, contact the nearest police station to have the fake money turned over. Fern Keery, ZNS Network News.
The impact from Sunday's massive blaze on Jenny Street has brought the Engleston community closer. As those fire victims continue to rebuild, Kelsey Johnson tells us that the Royal Bahamas Police Force is lending a hand.
The care packages presented to Bishop Darren Woods, senior pastor of New Goodwill Church of God in Pairdale, Angleston. It is the distribution center for those affected by Sunday's blaze in the Jenny Street area. The initiatives, part of the Royal Bahamas Police Force outreach community effort. Police Commissioner Paul Rowe says the donation is a small but tangible way of giving back to the church and the people.
Since the inception of COVID, persons were falling on hard times, and we have partnered with persons in the community, business people, to help relieve some of that. And today, this is just a continuation of that. We have put together our own resources now and try to do our little bit.
Woods admits Sunday blaze placed a strain on the already burdened over the hill community.
And initially after the fire, we came down that night and did an assessment, and immediately with the support of some of our colleagues, we were able to start collecting clothing, some food items. And from our pantry, we were putting together the various grocery packages. So this will be an added support to that, because we know that there is an initial need. And, you know, you could speak all the heavenly language you like, but if a man is hungry and he don't have no place to stay, he ain't hearing you at all. So there are some needs that has to be addressed. And we know that when Jesus walked this earth, every need he saw, the first thing the Bible declared that he had compassion. And then he met the need.
The police also extending assistance to those impacted by the Fritz Lane fire this past Tuesday.
We want to encourage persons who are affected by these fires, in particularly the one at Jenny Street, to go to the Roadford Police Station and make a report there so that they would be assisted in the quickest possible time. And the folks who were affected at Fritz Lane and 7 Terrace, they can go to the Sutton Police Station and make their report there. And the officers there would assist them in a timely manner.
Kelsey Johnson, ZNS Network News.
Well, BTC is doing it again. Its community give back is set for tomorrow. Since the pandemic, the telecommunications provider has been making it a little easier for families, providing necessities to get them through. During the Christmas, BTC held its big, big giveaway, providing monetary support to 5 charitable organizations. And each month, the BTC team lends a helping hand to the Great Commission Ministry. Tomorrow, team members will roll up their sleeves and head to the parking lot to give back. We talked to Head of Communications, Inderia Colley.
BTC will be hosting its community give back grocery giveaway tomorrow morning. We'll be at our JFK location from 8 a.m. So all you need to do is stay in your vehicle. You wear a mask. Once you drive up, you pop your trunk. We place a box of groceries inside and you're good to go. So we'll see you tomorrow morning at 8 a.m. We're definitely really, really happy that we have the opportunity to be able to give back to our community in their time of need. So we're encouraging everyone, if you know someone, please let them know.
Moms, we will never be able to thank you enough for always being there for us, protecting us, and teaching us how to maneuver through life. And this Mother's Day, we want to honor you in a very special way. So we are asking for you, the public, to send a video tribute of your mother and mother figure to k.sims@zenasbahamas.com and watch it air live on the Morning Edition the week leading up to Mother's Day.
This portion of the news was brought to you by McDonald's. McDonald's, I'm loving it.
This Mother's Day, you're going to need the card with Nuff Rewards. Not your credit or debit card, your Bahama Health Card. Enjoy discounts and promotions featuring all the things mom loves. Flowers, spa and beauty treatments, appliances, health, fitness, relaxation, food, and treats. And mom, if they don't buy it for you, you can buy it yourself. Yeah, Bahama Health got you, mom. Visit BahamaHealth.com for further details. Happy Mother's Day.
Available at Jimmy's Liquor Stores or your favorite restaurants and liquor stores throughout the Bahamas.
Becoming a BTC postpaid customer is fast and easy. And what's more, by signing up, the deals are instant. Tell us about some of the deals available for postpaid customers.
Well, we always have amazing deals available for our postpaid customers. We have up to 75% off any device that we carry, and you can also get up to $300 off of a phone if you're an existing customer. A new customer, you can get a free phone. And that's some of the amazing deals that we have at any of our major stores.
Let's talk again about switching over from prepaid to postpaid.
Okay, when you switch over from prepaid to postpaid with any carrier, you can keep your same number and you can come into a BTC store and your service will not be interrupted at all. Your friends and family won't even know that you made the switch.
And for new customers, what is the process like for them to become postpaid customers?
For a new customer, you just walk into the store, have a government-issued IDs, passport, driver's license, stuff like that. And once you do that, it'll be that simple. You could just visit one of our reps and they'll help you.
And tell us about some of the postpaid packages.
We have packages that suit any lifestyle and any budget. And whether you're homeschool, whether you have working from home, whatever it is, we have something there that will suit your budget.
So what are you waiting for? Visit any of our BTC locations and sign up and become a postpaid customer. It's fast, it's easy, and it's rewarding. These are still the moments that move us. I'm Corbell Pyfrom. Be well, and be back here next BTC Connection.
When you want to save money on your tile supplies, who are you going to call? The Tile King. When you tile your house and you want to look good, who are you going to call? The Tile King.
Visit the new Tile King showroom, which is internationally recognized as the finest tile showroom in the Caribbean, located in the Builders Mall on Wolf Road.
The Tile King. Who are you going to call?
Tiles on everything.
Shell Unleaded improves your fuel economy, giving increased miles per gallon, allowing you to do more of what you really want. Special additives used in Shell Unleaded improve your engine's efficiency. So go further with Shell Unleaded. Venture out to beaches, junkanoo, and festivals, and bring home memories that will last a lifetime. Shell, fueling journeys that matter.
The new Deputy Freedom of Information Commissioner sworn in today, Shane Miller, received his instruments of appointment during a brief ceremony at the office of the Governor General on East Bay Street. Attorney General and Minister of Legal Affairs, Senator the Honorable Carl Bethel, reiterating the importance of the office being established.
I had reason to point before, and I will refer again to the host of laws recently passed to impose discipline, transparency, and accountability in all aspects of financial management. The Public Procurement Act will require now that every year a list of every entity or person who has received the benefit of a government procurement contract is published, so people could look and see who's getting too much and maybe ask why, or who's getting too little, or who hasn't gotten. You know, this is the kind of transparency that we are not used to as a country, and we will have to become acclimatized to, because it is the demand of the people that they should be empowered with more information.
Thankful for the appointment, Miller noted that the new office establishes an environment that Bahamians can benefit from.
Our first immediate task is to onboard the consultant. The consultant's role will be to set a plan, a rollout, and a roadmap of what the office should look like, and any suggestions using international best practices. So that's our first thing. We intend to be involved with civil society and the government. And as the AG said this morning in the speech, freedom, information itself is power. And the whole purpose of freedom of information is to bring that power to the people itself, and not just an agency of government, but to the people itself. And so we intend to definitely bring the power to the people.
Well, it doesn't take a mathematician to figure out that the Air Navigation Services Agreement signed yesterday will lead to big bucks for the local economy, and at a time when it really needs it. Tourism and Aviation Minister, the Honorable Dionisio D'Aguilar, disclosing that based on the fee structure, the first year should yield between $20 and $30 million.
And then obviously right now we're in a depressed aviation sector. COVID-19 has significantly impacted the aviation sector. And we envision over time this growing to $30 to $40 million. So I like to say, over the next 10 years, we're signing today, a $300 to $350 million deal today.
And just in case you're wondering how these fees will be collected.
Typically what happens is that when you purchase your ticket, all of these fees are embedded in your ticket. And there's an organization called the IATA, the International Air
Transport
Association, which is like the Chamber of Commerce for all airlines. And all of the fees go to IATA. And IATA then takes that money that you would have paid for your ticket and breaks it out between some goes to the airport, some goes in government taxes, some will go in these fees. And that is how monies are settled in the aviation sector. So once you, these fees will be built into your tickets.
As for those built-in charges, the minister says this should total a small amount, perhaps just over a dollar. Ocean exploration, one way to see Eagle Ray Empress or Nikita Shiel roll. She, along with filmmaker Lovato Stubbs of Conk Boy Films, recently produced two documentaries exploring the importance of the ocean that surrounds us and our relationship with it. Jiminy DeSwain tells us more in this week's edition of Catching the Feeling.
Director Lovato Stubbs is always pushing his creative side, and this time he paired that with the work of a conservationist hoping to get Bahamians to fall in love with the ocean as much as she has.
You know, my roots is in Cat Island, where we shot the documentary. We also shot, you know, the documentary in Nassau as well. So it's a two-part sort of documentary connecting our love with the ocean. It was a powerful project, you know, worked on this amazing project with Nikita, also known as Eagle Ray Empress, and she was on the journey with me every way. We like to call it Bahamian magic.
And magic it seems, as bodies of water explore a complex issue.
As, you know, as I shared in the interviews in the film Bodies of Water, for many Bahamians, we have a very unpleasant relationship with the ocean. We don't know how to swim. Many of us all probably know someone who's died as it relates to the ocean. You know, so there's a lot of fear.
Antonise, in the film set in Cat Island, comforts her fear of the water, connecting with her heritage and finding a new love. Meantime, Bodies of Water helps the viewer get reacquainted with history, exploring identity and many other stories that need to be shared.
I think we've been challenged to really have open and honest conversations about how the colonial history of the Bahamas impacts our national development and really what that means to each and every individual.
For Stubbs, film was a great way to share the message.
We want to use the tool for filmmaking to tell our history in a really great way. So not only us locally as Bahamians can learn our history, but the world can learn our history. The plans is to do more projects like these two documentaries.
Roll hopes the story creates a way for a larger conversation about the ocean and its benefits.
I mean to be a Bahamian who spends their time under the water and who can and can see what the water has to offer. And then how can we tie this into new like national development models for the creative economy and which is the orange economy, or the blue economy being the ocean economy. And
anyone looking to watch either film, Bodies of Water or Antonise, can do so at the One Only Watch website. Jiminy DeSwain for Catching the Feeling.
Well, as we head to the break, we'd like to thank all our viewers watching us live on our social media platforms. And just in case you missed the news, be sure to head there to catch up. Stay with us. There's more after the break.
Today is a day for fun. Today is a day for family. So why should yesterday's worries affect my today? That's why I insure my family with J.S. Johnson, because their mission is to provide us with the best insurance coverage possible. With J.S. Johnson, I know my family comes first, so I take comfort in knowing that they always have us covered, providing us with a great today and an even better tomorrow.
J.S. Johnson Insurance Agents and Brokers, giving you peace of mind.
guys. It's Shay again with another quick tidbit on the perks of being an Alive customer. Now, if you're already on our network, this may just be a refresher for you, but if you're not, this might give you that extra push. If you're interested in getting a bill every month, or you're interested in the best prices on some of the latest devices, or if you've been a little bit interested in that auto pay option, this might be for you. It's time for you to join Postpaid and experience opulence.
Simply put, being an Alive Postpaid customer means you selected the plan of your choice and you then pay for that plan routinely every month. Unlike prepaid, where you can fluctuate between 7-day and 30-day, all postpaid plans are 30-day plans. So what are some of those postpaid plans? We have our Liberty More, which is $59.99, gives you 10 gigabytes of data, 500 talk and text minutes. Or we have our Liberty Premium, which is $99.99 per month and gives you 20 gigabytes of data, 1,000 talk and text minutes. Or we have our Liberty Elite, which is $149.99 a month, includes unlimited data, talk and text, and 1 gigabyte of roaming data. Again, all of our plans include unlimited Alive to Alive calls and texts. Now listen, we also have postpaid MiFi plans. That's right. If you have a MiFi device, you can purchase postpaid data plans, MiFi Basic, MiFi Plus, and MiFi Preferred. So what else can you look forward to? Even though we are still practicing social distancing during this time, as a postpaid customer, you not only have access to exclusive offers and devices, but exclusive invites to virtual events hosted by Alive in partnership with local vendors and access to special offers at many vendors on our List Rewards app.
So there you have it. If you're a prepaid customer and you've been thinking about making that postpaid switch, we hope that this helped. If you're not an Alive customer, what are you waiting on? Alive, believe in best.
May 10th, 1980. The date etched in Bahamian history.
Barbarism, which is one way one could describe the acts that were perpetrated against us.
I've never heard really of anyone sinking a boat and shooting men over fish.
The nation stood still as news emerged of the bombing of the HMBS Flamingo.
One of the Cuban MiGs fly over the vessel.
They came back with another blaze of fire, and this time they hit the vessel straight down the center of the vessel.
I saw my shipmates scurrying and running and screaming, some starting to jump into the water because by then the Flamingo had caught fire.
And the killing of four young Bahamian men.
Fendrick Starr, we were swimming together. All of a sudden he started shouting, help, help, help. I said, swim, man, swim.
I get ready for chase. Marty called me from wake. Then she tell me what happened. But I wasn't thinking. None was that was my son.
Join ZNS TV 13 as we bring you The Ultimate Sacrifice, the HMBS Flamingo story with Beverly Curry, Sunday, May 9th at 8 p.m.
Colon cancer is the third most common cancer affecting Bahamians. Your risk of developing colon cancer is increased if you have a personal history of colorectal cancer or colon polyps, a family history of colon cancer, or inflammatory bowel diseases such as ulcerative colitis. Other factors that can increase your risk of developing colon cancer are low fiber, high fat diets, a sedentary lifestyle, obesity, smoking, and alcohol. You can take steps to reduce your risk of colon cancer by making specific lifestyle changes. Eat a variety of fruits, vegetables, and whole grains. These foods contain fiber, minerals, vitamins, and antioxidants, which may play a role in cancer prevention. Drink alcohol in moderation or not at all. Do not smoke. Exercise with a goal of getting in at least 30 minutes each day. If you've been inactive, start slowly and gradually build up to 30 minutes. Also, talk to your doctor before starting any exercise program. Maintain a healthy weight. If you're at a healthy weight, maintain it by combining a well-balanced diet with daily exercise. If you need to lose weight, ask your doctor about healthy ways to achieve your goal. Colon cancer screening can also help to prevent colon cancer or lead to its early detection when treatment is most effective. If you're 45 years or older, speak to your doctor about having a colonoscopy or some form of colon cancer screening that may be appropriate for you.
What you see on this television station is governed by IRCA's Code of Practice for Content Regulation. The Code of Practice covers matters relating to program content that are of concern to the community, such as local content, news, current affairs and programs for children, advertising, including political advertisements, and the responsibilities associated with broadcasting in the Bahamas. The code also covers aspects such as access services for the hearing and visually impaired, and the procedure for lodging a complaint about anything broadcasted by this television station. The code is available on IRCA's website at www.IRCABahamas.bs. To receive a copy of the code by mail or in person, you may telephone IRCA at 242-393-0234. Family Island dialing is toll-free at 242-300-8722.
We play just like your kids. We text just like your kids. We learn. We even cook. We take selfies. We have hobbies. And we love sports. In every way, we are just like everyone else and enjoy the same things and live our lives every day just like you do. So if you happen to meet us, treat us just like everyone else. Because at the end of the day,
we're just like you.
Living life with Down syndrome is simply living. To learn more about Down syndrome, call 727-2105. This message is brought to you by the Grand Bahama Down Syndrome Society.
Ministry of Tourism and Aviation officials preparing for the historic contract signing and groundbreaking for a new international airport in Georgetown, Exuma, tomorrow. According to Director of Aviation Algernon Cargill, the government has invested $65 million to construct a 60,000-square-foot aviation facility that would serve as the major commercial airline hub in the southern Bahamas.
Construction should take approximately 24 months. The contractor, 24 months. The contractor has told us that he should have the project completed in 20 months. The airport is approximately 60,000 square foot, will include a rental space, as well as opportunities for spin-off business in Exuma. The construction will start immediately after the groundbreaking. Of course, the contractor has to do some preliminary work to get the grounds ready. And what is particularly important and beneficial to Exuma is that he will be hiring directly from Exuma as a part of his strategy. And we are very happy about that, that he's hiring initially from Exuma, because it means he will be creating immediate employment in Exuma. And his strategy is that they will only hire outside of Exuma when the local talent does not exist.
And Exuma residents would be pleased to hear they won't have to travel too far to use the new airport, as it will be built west of the current facility near Odyssey Aviation.
We plan to repurpose the current terminal at the end of construction into airline space or retail space, but something that's going to jumpstart or continue to add to the economy of Exuma. And it's a completely new complex that's being built on the aerodrome property that's owned by the airport authority. And as I said, it's 60,000 square foot of space that we're constructing there. We have a separate groundbreaking very soon afterwards for the airside, which will be the runway and aprons and taxiways. And that project is going out to tender imminently also.
I'll be sure to tune into live coverage of the Exuma International Airport contract ceremony on the ZNS network beginning at 12:25 tomorrow afternoon. 10 of the country's best national parks for uncrowded exploration featured in today's edition of USA Today Travel. The online article highlights the Bahamas National Trust, its formation, the first national park in Exuma, and how many national parks are in the Bahamas. Number one on the list, Inagua's National Park, followed by others in North Andros, Abaco, Exuma, Grand Bahama, Eleuthera, and right here in New Providence. The online travel article noting that as travelers yearn to return to the Caribbean, the Bahamas remains the closest option for much of the United States, and the country's national parks offer the safety of being outdoors and distanced for an island getaway. Well, it's time now for a check on Family Island weather with Chief Meteorologist Basil Dean. Good evening, Basil.
Good evening, Makisha. Some much-needed rains today in parts of the capital, and that was courtesy of a brief frontal activity. We'll tell you more about that later on in the newscast, so do stay tuned. But outside of our studios, we are under partly sunny skies despite the cloudy conditions we had earlier today. Temperature at 82 degrees, relative humidity 73%. The winds are now out of the south at 10 miles bar. The barometric pressure, 1,016.0 millibars. That's 30.00 inches, and the pressure is steady. Temperatures around the islands this evening, they are brought to you by Family Guardian Insurance Company. We are protecting you. 82s in Freeport, Grand Bahama, and Grand Ole Key. Marsh Harbor, Abaco, 81 degrees. 81 also in the Berry Isles. Allistown, Bimini, 82. 81 in Harbor Island. Rock Sound, Eleuthera, 82. Otterstown, Cat Island, 81. 82 in Stanley Key. Kemp's Bay, South Andros, and Fresh Creek in Central Andros. San Salvador and Rum Key, 81s. 82 in Georgetown, Exuma. We get back into those 81s in Ragged Island, Clarence, Sound Long Island, Crooked Island, Betsy Bay, and Ackland, Smatchy Town, and Agua, 82 in the Turks and Caicos Islands at 80 degrees. And your Bodie forecast tonight is brought to you by Builders Mall, home of FRP, the Tile King, and the Paint Center in the northwestern islands. The winds are going to be south to southwest ahead of that approaching front, speeds around 10 to 15 knots, and the wave heights 2 to 4 feet. Low tide will take place tonight at 11:38. In the central and southeastern islands, southeasterly winds 10 to 15 knots, and the wave heights 2 to 4 feet. Tomorrow, in the northwestern parts of our country, the winds become southwest to west at 10 to 15 knots. By late evening, heading into the night, time, those winds will swing out of the northwest behind that front. Wave heights 2 to 4 feet, high tide tomorrow at 5:42 in the morning, low tide at 2 minutes past midday. And for the central Bahamas, the winds are going to be light and variable with flat seas tomorrow in the southeastern islands. Easterly winds 10 to 15 in the wave heights 2 to 4 feet over the ocean. Now, as we take you into Saturday, those winds are going to rotate quite rapidly, becoming northeast to east after that front has passed. Speeds picking up 12 to 18 knots, wave heights also building 3 to 6 feet over the ocean, so we'll put some caution flags in place for your boaters on Saturday for the northwest Bahamas. High tide will take place on Saturday at 6:27 in the morning with a low tide at 12:42 in the afternoon. In the central islands, easterly flow 10 to 15, wave heights 2 to 4 feet. In the southeast, the winds will be southeast at 10 to 15 and the wave heights 2 to 4 feet. That's going to do it for your boating forecast. It's time now for your international temperatures, and they are brought to you by Royal Star Assurance. International temperatures brought to you by Royal Star Assurance. But stay tuned. Extended weather forecast is still ahead.
Everyone's excited about the $8 meal of the day. Every day, it's a different 6-inch sub, plus chips and a 20-ounce drink for just $8. That feels like fresh value. Come in any day of the week for one of your favorite 6-inch subs. Like turkey breast, meatball marinara, sweet onion chicken teriyaki, Black Forest ham, Italian BMT, oven roasted chicken and tuna. Then add chips and a 20-ounce drink and you've got the $8 meal of the day. A great meal at a great price every day of the week, only at Subway.
May I have your attention, please? This week's specials at Super Value and Quality Supermarkets include Best Yet Cornflakes, 18-ounce box, $2.49. Hunt's Ketchup, 32-ounce bottle, $2.39. Fresh Yellow Corn, $3 for $1.99. Chicken Leg Quarters, 10-pound bag, $1.19 per pound. Best Yet Evaporated Milk, 12-ounce can, 95 cents. Super Value Winton opens Sunday, 7 a.m. to 5 p.m. Super Value Cable Beach opens Sunday, 7 a.m. to 8 p.m.
The $20 combo, unlimited talk, yo, to every network you know. Across the Bahamas, I got 6 gigs of data, plus unlimited chat. It's a scroll over two. Now let me check my people on Facebook and WhatsApp. BTC is where it's at. I rock my combo.
Your BTC 10-day combo is now only $20 and is supersized with a new low price.
BTC.
Colon cancer is the third most common cancer affecting Bahamians. Your risk of developing colon cancer is increased if you have a personal history of colorectal cancer or colon polyps, a family history of colon cancer, or inflammatory bowel diseases such as ulcerative colitis. Other factors that can increase your risk of developing colon cancer are low fiber, high fat diets, a sedentary lifestyle, obesity, smoking, and alcohol. You can take steps to reduce your risk of colon cancer by making specific lifestyle changes. Eat a variety of fruits, vegetables, and whole grains. These foods contain fiber, minerals, vitamins, and antioxidants, which may play a role in cancer prevention. Drink alcohol in moderation or not at all. Do not smoke. Exercise with a goal of getting in at least 30 minutes each day. If you've been inactive, start slowly and gradually build up to 30 minutes. Also, talk to your doctor before starting any exercise program. Maintain a healthy weight. If you're at a healthy weight, maintain it by combining a well-balanced diet with daily exercise. If you need to lose weight, ask your doctor about healthy ways to achieve your goal. Colon cancer screening can also help to prevent colon cancer or lead to its early detection when treatment is most effective. If you're 45 years or older, speak to your doctor about having a colonoscopy or some form of colon cancer screening that may be appropriate for you. I'm Dr. Eugene Marcus Cooper. Pay attention to your health. Get the facts and discuss colon cancer with your physician today.
This message is brought to you by the Ministry of Health in partnership with the Public Hospitals Authority.
ZNS Total Sports is brought to you by 4th Terrace Diagnostic Center.
Welcome to sports. Buddy Hield registering 16 points, 8 rebounds, 8 assists, and 2 steals across 40 minutes of play in Wednesday's win over the Indiana Pacers. Hield ended just 2 rebounds and 2 assists shy of posting a triple-double. While seeing an uptick in his workload, he's now attempted 15-plus shots and 10-plus three-pointers in each of his last 3 games. The Kings' sharpshooter has been a reliable threat, scoring in double digits in 8 of his last 9 games. Buddy, on his new role.
More opportunities. I've been like being myself lately, but I feel that, you know, when I'm stretching out and picking rolls, I feel like it's a high volume play for us because team, you know, a lot of people might not think it's a high volume play. They want me to stay space, but I feel like it brings more offense to our teammates because they have to blitz me. If I can't, they let me come up wide open, then if they hit the roller and Rashawn. It triggers Rashawn to be free, and he hits the ball at the corner, or he'd be able to finish. And you see how Rashawn plays. He's pretty mobile, so catching the ball in that 15, 17 foot range, he can make plays of that.
DeAndre Ayton posting 7 points, 8 rebounds in the Suns' 135-103 loss to the Atlanta Hawks last night. A quiet performance from DA, who talked about impact in the game outside of scoring.
Well, my name is Dominating, I do everything. I'm a dominating the game regardless. When I'm in the game, I'm dominating the game, both ends. I create offense for my guys, and, you know, they create for me. But, you know, I'm the main vocal point when it comes to pick and roll, rolling to the basket, new shooters open. And everybody know I'm the anchor on the defensive end. You know, I take all the responsibility on that end. But, yeah, that's what dominating is, man. I don't really come into the game saying I'm going to score this or that. I just come in trying to be the best superstar I can be with my effort. You know, that's what I look at as, and, you know, try to be the best two-way I can.
And that's been a look at sports.
ZNS Total Sports is brought to you by 4th Terrace Diagnostic Center.
Mario thought he could have his cake and eat it too. He almost found out the hard way that if you don't insure your home for the full replacement value, when it comes time to make a claim, you won't get the full payout. It's called the condition of average. If your $200,000 home is destroyed by a hurricane, but you only insured it for $100,000, half the value, you'll only get half of that $100,000 payout. Actually, less than that, because there's also a deductible, which will be deducted from your payout. Check your home insurance policy for the condition of average clause and ask your insurance agent or broker how condition of average would affect you. This message was brought to you by the Insurance Commission of the Bahamas, protecting the interest.
Conversations with Christ every Sunday at 10 a.m. And I'll tell you why. Because God said 1,000 years is like a day for me. And that's why you could have a thief on the cross pray for just a few seconds and get forever and get forgiveness and get eternity. So every single Sunday for 30 minutes, we're going to praise God together. So every Sunday at 10 a.m., Conversations with Christ.
Time now for weather.
In our final look at weather, we had some showers earlier today here in the capital, and that was courtesy of a little trough that moved through the area ahead of a front system that's heading this way. But there are some pre-frontal activity now approaching the Grand Bahama and the Abaco area that will occur during the course of tonight, and by the early morning, by tomorrow morning, we expect the frontal boundary itself to start making its way through the extreme northwestern parts of the country. By afternoon tomorrow, showers will start developing here in the capital again, somewhere in the vicinity of 1 o'clock thereabout, and those showers will continue sliding towards the southeast. The front itself will not push through us until about evening time, say around 8 o'clock in the evening, and then that too will eventually push towards the south of us, stall out a bit, remaining in the area, so those showers will hang around right through our Saturday, and they can be heavy at times. So prepare yourself for some much-needed rains, which will be coming in heavy downpours at times. Our forecast for tonight goes for most of clear conditions. It's going to be humid tonight ahead of that frontal system. Temperature dropping off to about 75 degrees tonight. But then tomorrow, there's going to be intervals of clouds and sunshine in the morning. And as we head into the afternoon hours, you'll see those clouds start to thicken up. Showers start to move in, even some thunderstorms developing in the afternoon. And as we already told you, those thunderstorms could be heavy at times. 85 degrees for your high temperature tomorrow. The extended weather forecast, temperatures are in the mid-80s once we get that front through us, and that will hold right through the weekend. We'll see a gradual climb as of Monday, getting you back up into the upper 80s as of Monday, and that will carry into the balance of next week. But it seems as though the weekend is going to be off and on with some showers, as we said, hanging on right into Saturday. Maybe on Sunday morning, and I say just maybe, because Sunday's Mother's Day and we want a perfect day for you, but there could be a little stray shower in the morning, but thereafter, things should pan out quite nicely for you. Make it so.
Well, thanks, Basil. That does it for the Bahamas tonight. We thank you for continuing to make ZNS your number one news and information network. Only the sun covers the Bahamas better than ZNS. On behalf of the entire team here, thanks for watching, and good night.
You're watching the ZNS Network, the People's Station.
I'm Catherine Gomez, and welcome to A Mother's Love.